Good morning, everyone. Hi, guys. Welcome to Gateway Youth. It is so good to have you guys with us here this morning. I bet you weren't expecting to see this face again, but you cannot get rid of me that quick. So I'm back. I'm here to welcome you to this morning service. We are going to head into a time of worship, and then Lauren is going to give us a short talk on the Bible about grace. And then at the end, she's going to pray for you guys and do some ministry. So before I hand over to Rachel, I'm going to pray. But also don't forget, guys, to join us in the comment section. Type along. We'd love to connect with you in that way. So I'm going to hand over to Rach. But before that, I'm just going to pray for us now. So Holy Spirit, would you come? Would you flood the homes and the hearts of every single youth that's watching right now? Would you come and meet with us, Jesus? I pray that all of the hard stuff of the week, all of the busyness, we'd be able to come and lay it down at your feet and meet with you this morning. I pray, Lord, that you'd reveal your grace to us afresh today. In Jesus' name, amen.
To fight for me, sing a little louder in the presence of my enemies, sing a little or nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, and grace.
When deciding where to look in the Bible to talk from today, I was led to a book called Galatians, a little 6-chapter book written by the Apostle Paul, found in the New Testament. Tim Keller, a famous theologian, says this about Galatians. The book of Galatians is dynamite. It's an explosion of joy and freedom, which leaves us enjoying a deep significance, security and satisfaction. The life of blessing God calls his people into. Are you facing a situation right now where you need God's dynamite? Where you need an explosion of joy and freedom? Because if you're not in that situation now, then I can tell you that you probably will be in the very near future. If you can't see a way forward or feel like you're trapped, or it may be that there's a relational crisis kind of going on, or something that you're facing at home, with your friends, at school, in your study. If this is you, then I think God has a little something to say to you through the book of Galatians. I hope that although I'm only going to be reading a couple of verses, like I say, it's just 6 chapters, so maybe go away in the week. I'm hoping that you'll kind of become a little bit curious, go away in the week and read the book of Galatians. You will not be disappointed. So, back to this morning. As I've been captivated by this, I was wondering why. Then I realised it's because the book of Galatians brings us face to face with the core message of the gospel. And it's a personal impact on us. It talks about God's grace. And that's what I'll talk about this morning, grace. So my story, if you don't know already, is that I was personally impacted by this gospel message and this story of grace when I was at university. I had always had some sort of faith and kind of knowledge that there was a God, but I hadn't yet acknowledged that there was another personal step that you needed to take in opening up my heart to Jesus and acknowledging my wrongdoings and my need for him. It was such an a thing for me to kind of encounter Jesus, and that is what transformed my life. It was such a simple thing to do, and yet it totally changed my life for the better. I was desperate to know that God loved me and accepted me, yet I was also aware that I was not living up to God's standards. In my own strength, I just couldn't do it. I had tried, but I couldn't. The gospel offers us a way through the challenging life circumstances that we face, and especially if we haven't got peace. It helps us with that. The gospel is a source of hope and inspiration, which can often be overlooked. Today, I want to look at this gift of grace, which I believe will transform us wherever we are. Paul, this writer in the New Testament, often starts his letters with a greeting, grace and peace. It's a Christian form of a common Greek saying, but it's striking because it's a summary of the gospel. Grace is a gift we cannot earn, and it's from God. While his peace is the positive impact it has on our lives, which comes about through the Holy Spirit, and is one of the gifts of the Spirit, in Galatians 2:20 it says, I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. We cannot earn our salvation through works. It is God's gift of grace. We can try to earn our God's love, but it's a gift he freely gives. When I was younger, I'd crave my dad's attention, but he worked away a lot, and when he wasn't, he worked in his office. It's strange, isn't it? We want to try and earn our dad's approval, to try and earn relationship with our earthly father. I just want you to know that God is not like that. I don't know what your relationship with your dad was like. For some, it might not be great. So the idea that God wants to be our heavenly dad might be difficult. Yet it is the message of the gospel. It is the gift. I know that many of us know that, but the wonder of it, like, we can often forget that. It is a wonderful gift, this grace. My dad is great, and I know he loves me. Raising three girls must not have been easy, and he was never great at gifts, often forgetting my birthday altogether and not even getting a phone call. However, one Christmas, my dad came to my Christmas show at the place that I was working and told me he had seen this kind of terrible year that I'd been through, and he was buying me a return plane trip to South Africa. Growing up with a South African stepmother, I felt like it was kind of a part of my culture and a part of who I was, and I'd always wanted to visit. This ticket that I did nothing to earn or deserve was freely given to me. Can you ever remember being given a gift that you really wanted? A gift that you didn't really deserve? Jesus doesn't give us a rule book. He came with a gift of grace. This little book of Galatians is often referred to as Luther's book, as he relies strongly on this book for his teaching. He strongly disputed that freedom from sin could be purchased with money. Luther taught that salvation is not earned by good deeds, but received only by God's grace through faith in Jesus Christ. His teaching got him into some serious trouble and got him kicked out of the church, actually. Luther's teaching brought about an absolute explosion of joy and peace, a deep significant security and satisfaction as they realised God's gift of grace came through Jesus alone and not by anything that we could ever do. This is what we need to get hold of too. Through Jesus Christ, we have deep significance, security and satisfaction. This is God's gift, which transforms our lives, and then out of that, transforms others. This is God's gift to you this morning. Will you accept it as he offers it to you? I'm just going to pray now. God, thank you for your gift of grace. God, thank you that it is something that we do not deserve. It is something that we could never try and bargain and do things that you just want to give us. Your grace, your forgiveness, your mercy, and from that place, your peace. Thank you, Jesus. thank you that because of your grace, Jesus died. Jesus died for us. I thank you, Father, that you love each one of us intimately and personally. And I pray this morning that we would know this gift of grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great couple of weeks. See you in 2 weeks' time. Bye, guys.